Music is all around us. When you just sit outside, you can hear music. You hear the birds, you hear the crickets. And for me, it's like I hear waves. Like it's a tone, like it's, and I hear rhythm a lot. A rhythm that haven't been used yet, that comes from nature. You know, so that's how I look at it. Music is all around us.
Tim, of all the gifts you have, my favorite gift and the one that I've tried to rip off from you and steal from you as much as I could, back from Can't Stop the Rain to now, is there's something about what you do that no one else can duplicate. When you do a beat, it's not quantized, it's just all feel. And emotion and feel always went out over precision and structure. How did you get that? Is it from your childhood? Is it something we can learn? Is it something you can explain to us so we can get better at?
I think it's something that you said in your sentence. You said feel. It's a feel. It's like everybody bops different. Everybody moves different. I think it's about your perception of how you move. And people like, wait, I don't bob like that. Wait a minute, that's a cool bob. And then once you start, you see like me and Missy, how we bob, it transitions through the music. The music moved that way. And I don't know if it's just a feeling, like if it was syncopated, it just felt funny.
It feels to me like people that don't have that ability try to solve it by adding more to their tracks. You can get by with three tracks and do more damage with your feel than most people can get by with 200 tracks with no feel.
I think simplicity is the key. You don't need a lot. You don't want to clutter the song.
Yeah.
You want to add ear candy to the song,
but
you don't want to overpower the song.
Can you sleep?
Yeah.
You can disconnect?
You have to disconnect to refresh yourself, to reboot. It's like cutting off your phone. You know, like you're like, oh, let me cut it off and restart it. You know, it's like anything to hear different. Like I do that, I think I do that more often now. You have to walk away from it for at least about an hour or two, because what you think is not good wind up usually being great. But because you kept working on it and you trying to find these different things to it, that's the beauty, what I say today, having computers versus the analog. When you had analog, you had to use floppy disks. So it's, you just gotta live what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? But what computer, you can always go back and say, you can name it. Let me go back if you wanna move on to something else. Most of the time, I just leave it up and just walk away, watch a movie or walk outside and come back to it and just push play and forgot what I was doing. It's like resetting my brain and I hear it and then I hear it totally different every time. I did that with Justin too.
How do you know when you're done? That's my problem. I sometimes go too far.
Now, because music is, when I listen to, like I was riding the car, listen to Nina Simone, it's like, it's just a voice and her piano and a groove, but it's the song. It's just not a lot, it's just a feel. Once you got that feel, why are we trying to get more if you already mastered it?
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? Why are we trying to get more? You already mastered, everybody in the room going crazy. What are we trying to do?
And when I told you guys, get to that point and walk away, it's done. Don't start doubting and judging. And
just do it.
Like, once you got the feeling, when you stand up like I do, woo, I'm out. Print.
Yeah. And sometimes it could be off. We could add more. Like, we could have felt something. But the point is, the feeling never left. Yeah, you can always add something when the record be out, Jaycen could probably add it and say, damn, I should have put this in there. Let's add it more. But the feeling's already there. Of course, you know, it's like, you know, it's like a person taking a drug. Why, if you're already high, you don't need to get more higher. It's like, you high. Like, it just, what else? You more, what much more do you need? Like, you know, and I had to learn that myself, because a lot of people, and I learned that from artists. Don't touch it. Don't, I was like, what you mean? It's like, I could put this, and that just started to transition in me. And I'm like, and I just start listening to like I watched the Queen movie, start listening to all those records. It's not a lot of music. It's not like what I would think to be magical. And for me, I just start listening to old records. And like another one, Bites of Dust. I'm like, okay, what makes this record dope? Mm-hmm. So I went back recently, I'm like, man, ain't nothing but just a bass line. And that groove is hypnotic. Yeah. And
another one bites the dust, and another one gone, and another one gone.
another one bites the dust. I was giving my appreciation and love to you as a human being. And part of that appreciation was change. And how mind-blowing to me it was that you came into the game and everybody copied your sound. And when I mean everybody, everybody was skipping their beats. And he could have been like everyone else, keep his sound, keep going, continue with it, because he's the king of it, and say, okay, you guys are all my sons. He said, y'all can have that. I'm going in a different direction. Were you scared? Were you nervous?
No, I feel like I'm doing it now. I feel like, okay, I done did it for decades, for at least two decades. So I'm trying to come into, like, I look at my daughter now, and she'd be like, okay, dad. I'm like, yeah, because I'm good at this. So it's like a challenge for me to change up the way people move, because I feel like, what if y'all move this way? If everybody doing all like that, I'm like, okay, what if y'all swag it out this way? So if I put a snare, they're like, ooh. It's just one little touch. It's just like, you know, I just like to just do outside the norm. I don't like to be normal. I like to stay in the grid, but at least dip off a little bit. Just like dip off and when I mean dip off, it could be if you're using this kick, well, I'm gonna use this kick. It could be the same pattern, but it's gonna sound different because I choose different instrumentation than what you would normally choose. Like everybody use the same trap drum. Okay, why don't we use funky drummer drums with the same pattern? I love teaching young producers, like, damn. They'd be like,
teach us old guys too.
But I just like, it's just fun because I would be looking at their computer. I'm like, why don't you put that plug in over that plug? Oh, I never thought of that. I said, how long you had this shit? 4 years. I said, that's the whole beauty. This is, the sky's the limit. I was limited. Boy, y'all not limited.
Yeah.
It's just, you know, it's just digital crack. You got to know how to not get that, you know, which y'all are great at mixing.
Yeah, man, over there,
so. That, but all y'all like good at that. It took me time to figure that part out because I come from analog. Yeah. So I was had to get used to, like, my ears got adjusted.
I'm pre-analog. That's how much I've been doing it.
Wow. So, you know, it's damn. Hey, yo. That's that right there. Walking out the room. People don't know how easy y'all got it. Well, that was real. Yeah. Them tape machines, slicing, cutting. In my career, I had a chance to witness that because I started with that.
Wait, could you imagine in today's generation, because I came in right at the end, the analog stage, but I still got a taste of it. And luckily enough, I grew up in the music business, so I was a part of and aware of it, but only us three are gonna relate to this. We rewind the tape and we fucking was like, please God, you ready to play it back or add a record or do something? The tape would reel off the reel and then you had to get up, put the tape back on. The idea is gone. Like you're just dying. So now, like he's saying, you guys have the unfair advantage. The less you think, the faster you create.